Immunotherapy. Mm-hmm. Now, when I said that sometimes chemo carries a negative cloud on side effects, and that turns out not to be true, and I love the way you put it. Aspirin is chemo. I think androgen deprivation therapy can also be perceived as chemo with all the side. I mean, you experience side effects. I think it's more tagged with side effects. We all have chemo, but chemo comes with benefits, right? But immune therapy has the opposite problem. Everyone feels warm and fuzzy about it. And so, but I'm excited about it. Can you tell us where we are with immune therapy? Because it looks like it has a role in urology. It looks like it has a role in bladder cancer. And is it going to have a role in prostate? I think it will, right?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it already has one agent, FDA approved, Sapulisalt or Provenj.
Provenj, right.
Now, that is an immunotherapy that, you know, is more like a vaccine therapy. There's an educative process. You're trying to educate your own immune cells, your T cells and B cells, to go after and recognize a protein expressed on the prostate cancer cells, prostatic acid phosphatase. Okay, but I think when people are talking immunotherapy now, they're talking more the checkpoint inhibitors, you know, CTLA-4, PD-1, PD-L1, those sorts of therapies where you have agents like pembrolizumab or Keytruda that have over 20 FDA approvals across different cancers. And the natural question is, why not prostate? There's a lot of investigation in prostate. The early data shows that if you just treat a general population by itself with those agents like Keytruda or pembrolizumab, you don't get dramatic response rates. It's probably more in the 5 to 10% range. So you might need to do combination therapies. You might need to do more selective therapy. Certain patients have mutations in mismatch repair genes, and these can lead to widespread hypermutation across the genome. That provides more targets for your immune system to go after, and these drugs might work better in that patient population. It could be as low as 3% of patients with metastatic prostate cancer. It could be as high as 10 or 12% of patients, depending upon which studies you look at. But I think those patients are ideal. There's another gene called CDK12, where some data shows that it's present in about 7% of men with metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer. That leads to a lot of kind of focal tandem duplications of the genome that are highly immunogenic. And that, there's early investigation going on, but that might lead to good responses to immunotherapy as well. So there's a few approaches, one of which is the combination drug approach to try to make it work for a broad population. The other is the more targeted, find a genetic subset of patients that are going to respond well. And I think all this is ongoing. So I think it's promising.
But some people do qualify right now for Keytruda and these other. I mean, everyone's supposed to, if they qualify for Provenj, they get it. That's great. It's been out. But you do have a subset of patients that do qualify for some of these new immune therapies, right?
Yeah, those with microsatellite instability. It's from these mismatch repair genes.
But how do I find out that I have microsatellite instability?
Yeah,
how do I qualify?
Similar testing as you find out if you have DNA repair deficiency is that there's next generation sequencing technologies that'll test your tumor. And most of these are targeted panels, maybe 300 cancer associated genes they'll look at. They'll look at DNA repair deficiency genes. They'll look at mismatch repair genes, a whole host of other things that are involved as well. And, you know, there's technologies. We have a homegrown one here that Colin Pritchard developed, UW Oncoplex, but there's other ones out there. Memorial Sloan Kettering has theirs. There's Foundation Medicine, which is probably the broadest, easiest to access one. So usually these reports will not only give you information on the DNA repair genes, but they'll give you information on microsatellite instability mismatch repair genes.